Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video I am going to explain you about this project. This project is basically a shopping cart. Like if you can add, you can add some of the items like this one and this one, and you see the number is also going to change. Like if I add this item is already added. This item, as you see, the item number is also changed 6, and you can see the price of all this item. And if you increase the item, the price is also going to be changed. You can also remove some of the items. Or so this project we are going to learn today, so let's stay with me. For installing all the dependencies which we are required in this project, let's write npx create react app and shopping cart and press enter. And the basic difference between npx and npm is when you write the npx, it will install all the dependencies and execute them. But if you write the npm, it will only install, but it doesn't execute. So this is the basic difference. It will say it will take some time, so stay with the dependencies. It looks like this. And if you are using VS Code, then simply write code dot. It will open this shopping cart folder in your VS Code, as you see. And now move in the shopping cart folder, cd shopping, press and npm start. If you open your Chrome browser, it will look something like this. And and here is our folder structure. In this folder structure, I am going to delete all the unnecessary files which we are not going to use in this project. The first one, I select app.csn and app.test.js, logo svg, this one and this one. And you let's first import the React, import React. And I am using the function component, which is the name is app. And done something like check. And now you also have to update something in the index.js as well. And I also need one more things. I want to use the font also CDN link, because we are going to use the font awesome icon in this project. So for using this, you have to add the link in the head portion. And now and you I also create a folder which is named as component. We will put all the components in this component folder. Here I created an app.js file, and this will be our first component. And for using the navbar component, you have to write the navbar like this, and you also have to import at the top, otherwise it won't work. Now as you see, navbar component is rendered successfully. I'm going to write the Xen coding. This is Xen coding we called. Now it looks like this. And now we have to write the CSS for styling. And I'm going to create a new folder for where I put all the styles CSS files, which is an app.css. And for using these CSS files in this JS file, you have to import the CSS /style/navbar. Let's start our styling. Now it looks like something this, and we completed our navbar styling, and let us create another component for where we are able to, where we are add all the items which we want to show on our shopping cart. Here I create one more JS file, so which is the data.js, which contain all the items details like ID, titles, author, and image. I will put the link in the description. You can get this data, so don't worry. And now let's create one more component, which in this components file, let us create like amazon.js. Now repeat the same thing. Let's see whether it works properly or not. Don't forget to import at the top, whether it otherwise it don't work. So now it works in working properly. Let's create a section, and inside the section, first import the list. List dot map and item. Now let us create a one more component which for rendering all the rendering individual items, for which I put the name as card.js, and again write the same thing, import react and sfc cards cards. Now here cards, and if I render the component cards here, now as you see, the cards are rendered properly. Now it's time to add the data, provide the data to the cards, so that it will show properly. Now we also have to pass a key, otherwise it gives the error item.id. In the key you have to put the unique name. It may be something, either it number or string. Now let's pass the props, which is item. Datas from the item, which is ID, title, author, and price and image. Now again I'm using the Zen coding div, which I add the class is cards, and inside the card I have one more div which add the class is image box, and plus I need one more div dot details. Inside this I need three paragraph tag, and I need one button. Now in the first tag I am using the image, now as you see all the datas appears properly. Now let us make them in better looks better, for which we have to write some styling. Now in the styles files, I add one more files, which is amazon.css. For using this file you have to import as we did previous, import .\styles\amazon.css, and let's write down all the CSS. After writing the all the CSS, our projects looks like this, and now it's time to make our project to be functional. Now what I'm going to do, whenever a user click on the add to cart button, the data of this item is stored in the cart box, and the number is also going to be changed. If two items in the is present, then the number is also going to be two. If we so let us start, let's see how we can do this. First I'm going to now we also have to use the hooks, where like we have to import the use state, and let's create a function like handle click console.log and item. Now I am going to pass this function as a props, handle click. Here is the card, and handle click, and when the user click, we will pass the data. We will pass the data to the handle click function. Let us check whether it works or not. If we click on this first on the second item, we will get another data. Now it works properly. Let us add this data in our cart. When the user click on any of this button, we will push the data in this cart. So cart dot push item now console dot. Now let's see. First I click on this button, I will get one data. If I click on the second one, I will get two data, third one and fourth one. Now as you see, we get properly all the datas. So now print all this data when we click on this card button. So let us see how we do that. If the value of show is true, it will show the Amazon component. If the value is false, then it will show the some other data like cart. And we also have to pass this set show function to the neighbor component like set show. Now we move into the neighbor, and now when any user click on this my shopping, we will set the data set show to the true, and when the user click on this cart button, it will show the data. It will set show to the false. Now let's see it works or not. If we click on this shopping, that's because of we write something like this. If we are not adding this arrow function, it will automatically called. That's why. Now it works properly. As you see, when I click on this shopping, it will show this data. If I click on this button, it will show the cart. So it works properly. Let's instead of showing this cart, let us print the data which we are click on this cart button, known as uplifting. Uplifting means as we know that in React.js we are passing the data from parent to its child. So suppose I have some data, but I want to pass that data to the three. So what we have to do, we can uplift the data of two to the one, so that we can pass that data to the three. This concept is known as uplifting. So I want to uplift this data to its parent, which is our app.js. So for using this handle click function, I have to pass this handle click function to the Amazon component, not Amazon. Handle click, and let's see it works or not. Now it works properly. So this concept is known as uplifting.
And now instead of here writing cart, we have to pass a component which is let's create a new component so that we can print the data in the cart, like cart.js and import React and SFC cart. Cart now. For I have to pass this cart array such that I can access all the datas. Now as you see on all the CSS, and JavaScript code, and now let me explain you one by one. And as you see, the value of show is true, it will render the Amazon component, and if the value of show is false, it will render the this one cart component. And in this cart component, I am passing and set cart function and handle change function. Here is the cart and set cart, and here is the handle click function. When the user click on the click add to cart, if that item is already present in our array, then it simply returns, and otherwise it will push in the cart array. And here is the handle change function. Basically, whenever you click on the plus and minus button, it will increment or decrement the amount of that item. And this function, there is no need of this function, so comment out. And and let us move in the cart component. And here is the cart component. I am declaring a price and set price hook, price and set price state, which initialize the value to zero. And here is the handle remove function. When the user click on the remove button, that item is removed, as I show you in if you click on this add cart button, now you see these items are already added, and when you click on this remove button, that item is removed. So this function is called whenever we click on the remove button. And here is the handle price. Whenever any item is removed it will call the handle price function, so it will update that price. So and whenever this component is rendered, then handle price function is automatically called. So this this is our main code. And as you see, here is the I'm using the cart.map for rendering all the components. I can also create another component, but I don't create any other component, but you can create for better visibility or readability. So as you see, and I'm also going to show you the little bit CSS of which I written in the cart.css, as you see. So now this is our project. Let me show you properly. If you click on this cart button, that item is cart. And as you see, you can also increase or decrement the item. When you click on this increment and decrement, the price is also going to change. And when the value if the item is one, then you click on the minus button, it won't affect. So if you remove, the price is automatically changed. So this is our project. I hope you like it. So thank you so much.